Good afternoon from a very warm, very quiet, unusually enough, very dry, very busy, cloudy, grey Peterborough. First of all, sorry for not putting anything out for quite some time, but as the majority of you will know, we've been having a new roof fitted. So we've had the best part of 8 weeks of scaffolding, which went down a few weeks ago. And now we have a brand new roof. I'm well happy with that. So the last time I interacted with anybody was at the Newark show. And then before that we had a couple of visitors, which you will see in this video. So just a few thank yous and a few shout outs, because I did say in my next video I'll give these people a shout out. So Adrian and Teresa, you know who you are. Marty and Joe, bearing in mind I'm doing this without my glasses, so I've got no hands to put my glasses on now. Craig Chapman, Stephen Wales, Lee Adfield, you might not know the guy, I don't think so, everybody knows Lee, Andy, Graham and Bisley, which was lovely to see you guys, Phil and Claire, Crafty Coy, and just a little side note, glad you got things sorted out mate, don't need to say any more than that. Yeah, I had a good few hours at the Newark show, really enjoyed myself. But let's go see what we can see and what I've got for sale on Facebook Marketplace. Right, just a few things for sale, guys. Apart from two sets of golf clubs. They belong to my dad, though. I've got Superfish feeder, electronic one, 60 quid. Got a greenhouse heater, tenner. I've got a gravity water blade with a 3-inch out inlet and a 400mm, sorry about the noise, 400mm slipway. And then underneath that, the original 300x300 water blade. 3-stage dechlorinator with one new cartridge and two used cartridges. These ones I need for my big blue, but these ones I'm sure I can pass on to somebody. Make me an offer there. I think it's up for 25 quid. I can't remember, it's on Facebook, but let me know if anybody wants anything. And we'll move down the garden without falling over, hopefully. Oh, we've been doing a lot of gardening. Well, say I've been doing, I haven't been doing. In order to save a bit of money from this end, we've just left the aerator on. And there's an awful lot of movement from the goldfish. They're absolutely ravenous. Every morning I come down here and they're chasing me around the pond. You can just see them moving around there. So we've left the aerator on, but we've turned the water feature off to save a little bit of electricity. Moving down, the barrel collapsed and fell apart, so I had to make half a barrel and the rest will be burnt in the fire. Oh, looking forward to that. Cat's got another raised bed made out of the rafters from the old roof. So recycle, recycle, recycle. How's the pond doing? Well, this is where we had a little bit of a chat the other night, myself and Kat. Because we've been so busy with the roof, we've sort of, we've fed these, but we've sort of neglected them at the same time, so we haven't put any additives in the pond, we haven't put any medication in, we haven't had any fish out, we've just basically fed them and we haven't touched them. and strangely enough they are in pristine condition, and I'm just wondering if we're too eager at times to get our hands in and start messing around. I'm not sure. The only issue that we currently have, if I can actually find the little blighter, is one that's shaped like an S. That's the one, right there. Some kind of spinal deformity going on. As a few of you know, that you've got fish that are shaped like an S, so now we've got one. And that's happened over the last 3 months. It's just shaped like an S. The fish themselves are piling on weight. Can't believe how big these fish are getting. Quite happy with that as well. We also started using some quenicoi food, which I picked up from the Newark show. And no, I'm not being sponsored or helped out financially, but since we started feeding with the quenicoi food, they have gone ballistic in weight and hunger. I hope you can see that. So we're really happy with the growth on the majority of the fish. Some of the garden centre fish are never going to grow the way things are, but that's the way it is. Quite happy with that. Cat recently did a water check and I believe everything's all right, apart from...
Hello.
Apart from, was it KH?
Yeah, so the nitrate was slightly up, was 0.5, but we do sometimes run at that anyway. Nitrite and ammonia were zero, so we've obviously got some bacteria going on. And you put the pond bomb in after that anyway, so we need to recheck that because that was about a week ago. And KH, but we'd obviously had some quite big downpours in the week before, so it may just be that that's the rain has soaked up the bicarb in the water. And again, we'll check it again now that we've had a week without, well, again, not really any rain. Back to water in the garden.
Right, thanks for that, Kat. So another thing we've done is we've turned this water blade off, which has now made this area really quiet. So when we're not banging around, all the fish seem to gather in the deep end now, which is quite good to see. I'm not thinking for one moment these fish are parasite free, but they all seem pretty happy, to be honest. So in order to save a little bit of money, I've been turning pumps down. So this is now down at 30%, which runs the upflow filter. Only one air pump is running, which supplies the bottom drain and the biochamber in the drum. This is only used for extra air during the summer, and that is only used for cleaning for the upflow filter. I've turned down the pump that feeds the So I've turned down the pump that fed the backy shower, and in order to give it a little bit of assistance, I turned off the water blade, which I've just mentioned there. So I've saved a little bit of money there. And finally, the EA20000, which is running absolutely fine, I've reduced that down as well, which has produced some interesting changes, if you like. We'll go to the pond and have a look. I'll follow you. So what was happening during the height of summer, and I was running the EA 20,000 really fast, is we were getting a lot of bubble activity, which is still ongoing. So that's one of the outlets, and that's another. So I've been doing a bit of reading up, and I've got 1.5 inch pipe on the 20,000, which is asking for 2 inch pipe, because originally I was running it on an Aqua 40 10,000. So since I put a 20,000 on, which is clearly a lot stronger, and the high water temperatures, I was doing a bit of reading on cavitation. So we'll just have a look at the EA book, and straight away we have cavitation, and it tells you all sorts of things about having plumbing airtight, cleaning out leaves, increasing the pipe size, decreasing the suction pipe length, reduce the number of elbows, and verify the hydraulic compatibility. In a nutshell, look up cavitation on Google. I don't think I can explain it. Google might be able to explain it better. But when we add a higher speed return on the EA pump and higher water temperature, the bubbles that came out of the pipework was horrendous. It was honestly like boiling. It looked as though the place was boiling. I've reduced the speed of the pump, A, to try and reduce the amount of bubbles, and B, to try and save on a bit of electricity. And since I've reduced the speed of the pump and the temperature of the water has dropped, the bubbles have now decreased to just dribbles, if you like. So I have definitely used an awful lot of elbows on my pipework, and some long lengths of 1.5 inch pipe, and then put a pump on which demands 2 inch pipe. If you're suffering with bubbles the same as we are, and I say suffering, it's not creating any issue at all, it is just collecting bubbles, and apparently the propeller or impeller that's in the pipework, run at a certain speed, as I led to believe, creates voids in the water and creates gaseous exchange. Still not explaining that properly. Look up cavitation on Google. But yeah, temperature's gone down, speed's gone down, bubbles have reduced, in a nutshell. Interesting. So now here I am, almost in the roof of my garage, and when the scaffold has disappeared, I managed to salvage some of this scaffolding cover. So this is extremely strong. It's the type of stuff that they wrap around the scaffolding to keep the dust down. But I just thought to myself, if I can grab some of that and try use it as a cover on my pond over winter, sort of an extra cover, maybe it might keep a little bit of heating. I don't know. But these things come in 2 meters by 45 meter rolls. And I think I've got about 8 meters by 2 meters, but my pond's only 5 meters anyway. So I'm going to try roll that out in the garden, and so when it gets really cold, I'll put this across the pond. And I've also got some, my phone is going mental, I've also got some little bungee ropes in there which come with the scaffolding cover, and I'm going to try them, see what that does. Morning, Kat.
Morning,
Kat. Have you got some friends to talk to?
Oh, yeah, yes. Welcome.
Well, look who we got here. All the way from sunny Telford.
Morning, all. How you doing?
Pretty good, pretty good. And have you brought a friend with you, Phil?
Funnily enough, I have.
Yeah.
Hello.
Big beaming smile. What are you looking for? You been bitten?
No. Just nervous because you're pointing that thing at me.
I'll not point it anymore.
Nice.
So Phil and Aid have just popped in. They've got a prior engagement and they just thought they'd spend a bit of time here, get a few videos put in and get a cup of tea, maybe a biscuit if you're lucky, and then they'll be on their jolly way. But thank you both for turning up and having a look around the garden. Good morning.
Morning.
Can you give me your name, your age, your home and your profession?
I'm a window fitter. I live in the Black Country. My name's Aid and I've got a channel called Aid the Koi Keeper, which I've just set up, I don't know, about 3 months ago.
And your age?
56.
Oh!
Coming 57.
All right then. So, question one, Aid. How many koi keeping years have you had?
1.5.
1.5
years.
So, quite new to the game.
Very new.
Okay. Question two is, what is your current pond size and how many fish do you have?
It's 1,700 gallon. It's 10 foot by 6.5 foot by 3.5 foot at the moment. But I am going to put some windows in next year
and
hire it.
And how many fish do you have?
Oh, that's a good question, because I've lost loads and I've just put some more in. I think I've got about 16 in there now.
16,
again.
Okay. That's close enough. So you've just mentioned that you're going to be making it bigger.
Oh, yeah.
Question three was, is this your forever pond? So clearly it's not.
I can't make it any wider or any longer. I've got to go up because I've been warned by the guide.
Right, so let's say, for instance, everything that's associated with your koi and pond disappeared overnight, what would be your alternative hobby?
Go back into camera work, photographer.
Photographer, okay. You need to speak to Kat about that. Question five. During your 18 months of koi keeping, what has been your biggest triumph?
Trying to keep them alive.
Okay. Question six. Can you give any new koi keepers one piece of advice?
Well, that's a good one, ain't it, that one? Listen to the older boys.
Listen to the older boys, okay. Question seven. What has been your biggest mistake?
Being a koi keeper.
I can't believe these answers. Right, question eight. Future plans. So you've just said that you're going to make the koi pond deeper by creating some sides, coming up the sides.
Yeah, and I'm going to take the liner out and put a box liner in it and put a couple of windows in it.
Right, okay. Question nine. Could be an easy one, this. Do you get support from your partner?
Yes and no. When she's interested, she's interested, but when she ain't, she ain't.
Okay. And your final question, question 10. You might not have this particular fish, but what is your favourite koi fish?
Tancho.
A tancho. Thank you very much, Aidy. That is your 10 in 10. Right, so that's about it. Big thank you to Phil and Aid, especially Aid. Thank you for keeping it together, even though you're a little bit nervous on camera. I'll put a bit more feed in for the fish. So yeah, thanks Phil and Aid. Thanks for sticking with me. Thanks for the content from the other YouTubers for keeping me going over these 3 months while we got this roof done. Been a bit of a pain, but we're there and we're well pleased. And I'll try put some content out a little bit later. Check on Facebook because I've got some things for sale and I think the dechlorinator has gone already. So happy days. Anyway, in the meantime, two jabs, maybe three, maybe four now. Keep an eye out for that. Look after your family, stay safe and goodbye.